Leathur, Rokk. Welcome to my channel. This is the beautiful Atlantic Ocean behind me. And it is 5:10 p.m. And I want to talk about what happens when you have had a friend who's been wanting to be on your channel. And you've been talking about it and you see them on the street, as what happened yesterday. And all of a sudden they see a piece of your jewelry and that changes everything. Well, sit down and let me tell you a story. I was walking around on the boardwalk yesterday and I saw a friend, someone who is a very interesting person and who I think would have any of a number of subjects that I have covered on my channel and I think would work well with the content that I produce. And I've been wanting to interview this person or just, you know, have us do, like, maybe do a round table discussion with one or two others who have certain commonalities, and we could have something, one of these kind of videos where you talk about big issues and people who think deep thoughts, you know? Especially people who might not look aesthetically like they are deep thinkers, but I like to feature things like this on my channel. And so I saw this person, and right away he focused on my inverted pentagram. And one thing that I find problematic about this friend of mine is that, and I don't mean to be judgmental, nobody among us is perfect, but there are some people that if you let them talk long enough, sometimes there are some things that denote some cognitive dissonance going on. And like when I mentioned to him some things about I think that he would do well in Hollywood because he's an entertainer person. And he said, oh, I wouldn't want to be in Hollywood because there's too many demons there. And he's a person who, you talk to him long enough, he's a very devout born-again Christian believer, and he has been known to, one of the things he does is he does mixtapes, and he does Christian versions of popular songs, but he cleans up the lyrics so that they are no longer violent hip-hop, but they are godly spiritual stuff. So, and there's nothing wrong with that, again, but he's known me, oh, at least 3 years, and I don't make secret of the symbols I wear and stuff, but I have never been in a position where I felt that I had to hide aspects of who I am in front of friends. It's not like, okay, I could see if you're going to go into a house of worship, or if you are seeking out a discussion with somebody because you want to learn about their religion and you don't want to right away label yourself as the other. So maybe you would hide anything that doesn't pertain to the religion of the person that you're about to have a discussion with, especially if you want to learn about their faith, or you want to just, you know, learn enough about their text so that you can incorporate it into your own practices, which is something many ecumenical people do, and many pagans, for instance, will learn about other deities other than the deities that they learned about when they were growing up or whatever. So the chaos magicians, for instance, like to learn different kinds of tech from different cultures, even different sects of Christianity. There's different things that a person could incorporate into their own practices so that, say, they want to do a healing on a person who is a believer in those things, they have more tools to work with. It makes them more versatile for their art. So, but getting back to my friend, ever since he made an issue about my pentagram, things are different. This person, the energy is different between us, and I think it's probably safe to say I'm not going to have him on the channel unless he wants to try to debate me on the legitimacy of my tech. And I really don't want to entertain that. First of all, I don't need the stress. Second of all, I don't think that that kind of content, it's not like we're having a presidential debate where people have very strong feelings on both sides, but there might be, like, if my channel, you know that there is a general sway, a general, it's like if you go on to any of the major news networks, you know what the political bias is. You know what you're getting if you got watching CNN or ABC News or different things, whereas if you've got the Fox News channel on, you know your bias is going to be, going to veer left or it's going to veer right. And you guys know kind of where you're getting with my channel. And I have certain things that are kind of all aspects of my personality, and I find ways to explore different of my interests while I'm creating content that, while the focus might not be on any of those subjects, it still might color some things, even if it's just the wardrobe that I'm wearing when I am getting ready to film. But now this friend of mine, who already his extreme religious proclivities have kind of gotten problematic for him, because while there's nothing wrong with exercising your Second Amendment right to free speech and to freedom of religion, sometimes people do alienate other people when they're really, really hardcore about it, whether they're shouting from the rooftops Bible verses or whether they are actively coming up to people who have symbols that they are against for whatever reason, and they might get combative with them, saying, you know, what you're wearing is going to get you thrown in hell, or why do you wear this, or don't you know that my religious book says that you are going to be damned because you're wearing these symbols. And it just, nobody appreciates somebody coming up to them and telling them that they're no good, and that they believe in something that is going to damn them and whatever. And anybody who believes in or does any practices that are not minority, not majority practices, kind of knows what I'm talking about, where even if you're philosophically opposed to keeping certain things closeted for your own safety, for your own de-stressing, you're probably not going to flaunt all your symbols just because you know you're in the minority. You're going to have, what if you have some Christian that believes in what they did in the 1600s and 1500s, where they start lighting matches and stuff? You know, you have people that have very strong beliefs, and while you would like to think that people are now in the age of reason and you're not going to, even if you have very firmly held beliefs, you are not going to allow your biases to cause you to be violent to the other, right? I mean, I would like to think that we are not such, and certainly here in the United States of America, if we're American citizens and we have the basic culture, which is treat others like you want to be treated and basically don't be an asshole, you shouldn't have to worry about that. But the world we live in, where especially with our poorest borders, where we really don't know who our neighbors are, I've had a false sense of security because I'm a liberated feminist woman who's lived in America all her life, and I've taken for granted my general safety, and every now and then I'll find myself in public and I will misjudge someone's intent, and I have fallen victim to casual little acts of ghetto violence here and there. But that has not, I've not allowed that to poison me against people. But we need to be wary. But that said, if you're going to be living in an environment where your very friends are going to be prejudiced against your religion or something, because of that they're going to refuse to do prearranged business or whatever, you know, but I understand that's his prerogative. But just now I feel really awkward, and it's a shame. And this is somebody who, whenever I see on the street, I would always say hello and I would talk to them. But I saw this person a few minutes ago, and I was walking down the boardwalk, and I was headed to film anyway, and I was headed to film this very subject. And you know what? For all I know, I hope that I was not even noticed. You know, and I'm probably never going to, I'm not going to say I'm never going to talk to this person again, but I'm not going to seek them out, because I'm dripping in symbols that this person, every other word out of his mouth is talking about demons. And he doesn't like to be in front of certain casinos here because he claims there's too many demons. And, you know, I would never condone anybody's being rude or aggressive or violent toward strangers and things they don't understand, but I can almost understand why he was having problems in certain neighborhoods. Certain grown men didn't like his certain things, and I wonder if the aggressive Bible thumping, where you're carrying a Bible around and you're just being judgmental against people and cutting off whole classes of people because they don't seem to believe in what you do and stuff, it's not a good idea. So yeah, I'm always still looking for interesting, intelligent people that I think would be good to show on my channel, but sometimes you just have too many differences. And I'm afraid that may be what happened. So, here's the Atlantic Ocean. I'm going to do a slow turn around. I hope I didn't get any thistles on my ankles. Show you. This is very close to the Tropicana. Okay, I'll talk to you guys tomorrow. Be careful out there. There's a bunch of strange new people running around. Every town's a border town, remember that. I'll see you guys tomorrow. Bye.